Morning, Uncle Anton. Thanks for joining us this morning again.
Hi, Chad.
So this morning we're going to be talking about value and profit. And I think where we want to start is, which one do you think business should focus on?
Well, I think, Chad, to look at value and profit, one's got to look at what is value and what is profit. You know, and if you look at it in a business sense, value is really, or profit. Let's take profit. Profit is a result of your past. You've done a whole lot of stuff and you've done it successfully and you've now generated a profit. Value is really, the way I look at it, is value is something that to go into the future, to create sustainability, to make sure that the product, the quality, the service, the protection of your staff, the protection of your company, that's how you're going to go forward. And that's the value to me. And we're starting to, I think business today is starting to get that type of balance out of sync. We're all starting to focus on profit. Profit at all cost. You know, make money, make it quickly and get it done. And it's the consumer, we normally say it's the consumer that's paying the price here. But is it really the consumer now? It's now staff that's starting to pay a price as well. Business starting to pay the price of profit. And profit is short term, and we're seeing it all over. If you don't make money now, investors withdraw their money and you're here today and you're gone tomorrow because your profits weren't there. Nobody really cares about your value. What is the value? And how have you looked at the quality of your product? And that's the shameful thing, because small businesses start off by developing an idea that they believe the world should have, or the business they should be delivering, or they should fulfill, or where they can help the industry to do something, manufacture a widget that would help. Then unfortunately, because of the success at the small business approach, their demand gets a lot bigger. And then they have to go to the market to say, well, we need someone to invest in my business. And that investor and shareholder is eventually putting 100 rand in and he's expecting 140 rand back at all cost. He doesn't care. He doesn't care if you have to now cut your staff complement. You've got to cut certain of your production qualities to still produce the same number so that you can generate the same return, so that you can generate the same profit, and he gets the money for that. So we need to bring this back into balance. And I believe if our focus goes back to value, what is the value? And when we look at a profit value or the value of a business, is how well do you develop? How are you developing your people? How are you empowering your people to also be able to sustain themselves and sustain themselves in your type of business? And yes, it is like an old saying is, you know, there's no more employees. As if you're an employee, you're actually selling your service to a company. And the company is buying that salary by giving you buying that service by giving you a salary. They take that service, turn it into a product or a service delivery to the client, and they sell it on at a certain price. But what is the company putting back? What are we as company owners putting back in our people, instilling in our people, creating that that self-sustainability with every individual so that they understand it's a service they're selling? We haven't got time for that, because, you know, if we've got investors, we've got to worry about what does that investor's return, and they're going to sit in the boardroom meeting and discuss that with us and saying, well, I don't see the return. I think, you know, I need to withdraw. So many years ago, I did a presentation on death by shareholder demand. And I think we are in that era. You know, those years when I did it, I got into trouble because people became uncomfortable with it and didn't want to hear that they are actually taking or accepting profits at no consequence. Maybe we should have some sort of accountability and responsibility requirement from a shareholder and an investor as well, saying that when you are making that return, have you made sure that this profit that you've been given on the shares that you've acquired is done in a healthy manner, that it does create value. It does create value for the community. It does create value for the industry. It does create value for the people themselves. But we don't. So I think to a great extent, my question would be that if we are looking at our services that we provide, if we are as directors and as CEOs of businesses, what are we chasing? Are we chasing a profit? To have money in the bank at all cost? Or should we be chasing a lesser profit, but really look back and see we've created a better world out there? We've created a more sustainable world, more credible world, a world that we all can believe in again, that isn't here today and gone tomorrow.